G.Aravindan portrays the landscape of Kerala on all its smooth with a vision of a poet. For him, nature is not just a beautiful backdrop, it becomes an active participant in the narrative. But above all, he has the gift of the artist for endowing his people with an inner life.
I stand by my conviction. My total commitment is to cinema as a medium. I do not believe in shortcuts and cheap gimmicks. Subtlety is my style. I believe that is more acceptable and suited to our way of life, culture and aesthetics. I cannot overlook the importance of social values. I enjoy making movies that are in communion with nature.
Eyes as deep as the waters of the ocean, and voice very soft. He lent his personality to the films he produced. I may be right or wrong. One comes to know G.Aravindan through his thoughts, his pictures, his humming, and through the lines he draws. Isn't that the greatest achievement of an artist?
അരവിന്ദന്റെ ഡ്രോയിങ്ങിന്റെ സവിശേഷത ആണ് ആദ്യം പറയുന്നത്. അന്ന് കേരളത്തിൽ പ്രചാരത്തിൽ വന്നിട്ടില്ലാത്ത
What comes to the mind first is a characteristic of his drawings. The simple line drawings that were not yet in vogue in Kerala then. Today we have a tradition of line drawings. M.B., M. Bhaskaran, Cassius Panica, then myself, Nambudri, or some of those who popularized it among Malayali thinkers. Quite different from those, there is simplicity and a picturization which set G.Aravindan's drawings apart. Those were powerful contemporary portrayals. G.Aravindan, who was already a known painter, cartoonist at that time, also got interested in cinema, in the better kind of cinema which was being introduced in Kerala at that time. And it was very natural that in course of time, with the various associations, he also happened to take to filmmaking.
His
first film, Uttarayanam, was unique. I thought we had found a new genius. It was then that I decided to entrust my Kanchanasita to G.Aravindan.
I do not think that Sita should come in the film in the form of a woman. That is why she is interpreted in the form of nature, Prakriti.
Adhigam samsarikkade, ennal verum minda prani allade.
A man of few words, he was not withdrawn. He could convey a lot in very few words. Among G.Aravindan's pictures, it was Kanchanasita which appealed to me the most. That Srikanthan Nair's eloquent drama could be presented forcefully in so few words proclaims the power of visual art.
What a good writer achieves with imaginative use of language, cinema has to achieve with visual. It is here that one recognizes the limitations of technology and equipment.
I saw Thump, I think in 1977 at a private screening, and I was amazed. Amazed because it was so original, so fresh, and yet so simple. It was a story about yesterday and today and the changing times. And I think the circus tent was symbolic of change. And I particularly remember the shots of the children, the great faces which he caught, which were very candid, which were very lovely. I think those images have stayed with me and always will.
Of Aravindan, the first thing I think of is this incredible innocence and a great sense of wonder at life, because all his films from the very beginning, you know, each film has this great sense of wonder, you know, the wonder that makes a person into a poet.
My film Kummati is on a real personality and an assumed one. If he is not this, he will remain just as an ideal. And if remains as a concept, he will not get into the essence of the story. I wanted to show that apart from his supernatural image, he is also real. Through the mask he brings, I have related him to the animal forms as well.
Film from anybody else's, because the way he told the story, the way he held his images, or designed, let us say, visually designed his images, had a quality of emerging in a way that was very different from the way somebody tells you a story.
You see, Aravindan's and my friendship was really built upon a certain kind of silence. I know that sounds very funny when I say that, but I didn't speak Malayalam and he didn't speak very much to me in English. What we used to do is we used to go for walks. We used to walk. I love walking and he also seemed to love walking. And whenever there was nothing to do, in between films and so on, we would just walk together silently, without saying anything to each other, but together.
Aravindan asked me, "What is your script?" We were making a film for an exhibition on women of India. "What is my script?" He looked into the mirror. He becomes woman. He's no more a man. "This is my script. Becoming Sahaja, the Bhakti cult all over India, where men want to become undivided, no division between male and female, undivided, Sahaja." That was the script. That was the film.
ഇഷ്ടപ്പെട്ട പ്രേമമായിരിക്കും. തക്കാളി പിടിക്കുക.
the films I made, Estapan is still my favorite film. It is about a wanderer, a man without roots. Sometimes I wish I could be like him. Sensitive young man, slowly breaking up mentally. I had to cut the film according to the mood of the music. And I tried to give it a structure. I do not use symbols in any of my films. I feel that symbols are not a good technique, either for cinema or for any other art form. The dream Balu sees can be seen by anyone in Balu's state of mind. A few are dreams I had seen myself, and the rest are that of my friends.
You know, the first thing that comes to my mind when I think of Aravindan films is that effortless, elegant simplicity which he was able to achieve. That has always impressed me most. And there is one more thing about Aravindan films. To me, this is a very personal thing. I think Aravindan was making his films essentially for the Malayalis. The beauty of his films is that they had a tremendous universality, that they were shown all over the world also, but he was making it for the Malayalis.
இங்கிலீஷ் படிக்கணுமா? பதிலுக்கு எனக்கு தமிழ் சொல்லி தர முடியுமா? அப்படி இல்ல, அங்கங்க
He struck a rapport obviously between Smita Patel, who did Chidambaram so well, so beautifully. I mean, you take any of her scenes, whether she's in a garden or whether she's like a beggar outside a temple, Asmita went through a complete transformation there.
I like the story of Chidambaram, written by C.V. Sriraman. There were few specific reasons for making it into a film at that point of time. spending 3 years without a producer, I decided to produce this film as my own, which meant I have to cut down the expenses to the minimum. Chidambaram has only 3 characters. The village Mattupetti provides good backdrop to the film. There were also many friends to help me. Smita Patil had expressed her desire to act in one of my films much before this. Actor Gopi was also willing to come. When they learned that this was my own production, many artists came forward. No one acted in the film expecting any financial return. They did it for me.
The man has got so much of conflicts inside and put it only through his medium and not speak anything about it. When we ask, he says, I felt like that. The felt, the feeling has no words. So that he never wants to express it and makes another man to feel it. The man of such capacity never expresses it outside. But he puts everything in his true killer life. I had an opportunity of seeing his Vastuha. There is one scene, how he imagines the ship in the background, 2 persons sitting in the yard, speaking.
மரப்பண்ணி இருந்தா பிரேமம் தொடங்கியா
about my films. After all, there are many mysteries in life too. Maybe there is something intriguing about the character in my earlier film Estapan. Because Estapan was created by me and probably or partially at least projects myself. I would not still concede that there are mysteries in life.
Ah.